Welcome back. Now, if you've ever wondered how all these social greetings, whether you're talking about handshakes or high fives, how these came into existence, Nivea is coming to the picture. They're clearing the air. They're giving you some insights through their latest campaign. Building on their campaign, which is hashtag ban body odor, this is the one that wants to bring back bear hugs, if you please. We talked to Nivea India's Director of Marketing, Sunik Gadgil, about this new campaign and what really helps the brand click with its target audience. Sunil, great to have you with us on the show. If you can tell us about this latest ban body odor campaign, what was the thought that has been driving it so far?
The ban body odor campaign is for a product called the body deodorizer. What we've understood from consumer research is that body odor in our kind of tropical weather is a big issue. A lot of consumers face it, but very few people want to talk about it. So we wanted to bring it out of the closet in a sense, and we needed to do it in a way which doesn't really make consumers defensive. And that's what was the thought behind the campaign.
And what about this idea of promoting bear hugs? Where does that come from?
To really make body odor a topical point so that consumers can relate to the problem. As I said, not making them defensive about it, but trying to make them say yes. It is meant for me.
You've had brand ambassadors like Arjun Rampal, you've had Pariniti Chopra, as well as Anushka Sharma. How have their associations really impacted the brand? How has it really helped you?
I did with Arjun on our men's portfolio for now more than 2 years. The partnership has worked very well. He represents the values that Nivea wants to own, which is about being self-made, being honest, being straightforward, and being a family person. We hope that it continues building as it has built in the past.
You know, Sunil, when it comes to men's grooming category in India, the biggest market share belongs to deodorant. So how have the other products been doing for themselves? Have Indian men really opened up to the idea of men's grooming products? Because we see that category growing. Tell us really in real terms how much growth we've seen in that.
Indian men have owned up the responsibility of taking care of themselves. It's not only now that they do it between the four walls of their house, but it's an important thing for a man to be well groomed, because today the insight of the young generation is my face is like my business card.
And since there's so much action in the digital space, Sunil, tell us how you are using that to connect with your consumer, because this definitely lends itself to better initiatives. So how are the different ones that you've started already working out in terms of the kind of connect you can have and the reach you can have with consumers?
Nivea is using the digital medium more as a way of engaging with our consumers, more in the sense of communicating in a setup that is comfortable to the consumer, where the consumer can also give his own opinion or her opinion, and where interaction with the brand can be done on a scope which is more closer to the consumer's life.
For Nivea as a brand, Sunil, what do you think is the biggest USP, the key differentiator from the kind of competition that you have in this space?
Nivea has a very well-defined brand equity. It stands for making caring products. It stands for a brand which makes you comfortable in your own skin. And that sets it apart from a lot of other brands which are trying to tell the consumer that he or she can be more beautiful or far more better looking, not what they are naturally. Whereas Nivea doesn't believe in that philosophy. We believe when you feel good inside, you'll look good outside.
So keeping the landscape in mind right now, what are the key challenges that the brand faces in the Indian market?
The challenges of being a late entrant in a competitive market and a diverse market like India are obvious. You have a head start for competition, the supply chain, distribution, the branding. All the levers of the FMCG business have been built very strongly by others, and then the latecomer has to really come and give the consumers a reason to choose your brand on top of the others already available. So that's been the challenge. We are a typical challenger brand in the Indian context, and getting more and more consumers to choose Nivea by dropping the other brands that they have has been our business task.
And keeping in mind everything that's happening in the digital space, tell us what your media mix is looking like these days for the campaigns that you're launching.
Following the consumer is consuming TV. That's still the lead medium. and digital is being adopted aggressively, so that's our secondary medium.
Of course, even as innovation is the name of the game and people want to be disruptive and really do things differently, tell us about the fundamental principles at Nivea India that you follow when it comes to laying out a marketing strategy.
The principles of the marketing strategies have been very clear and simple. We are a challenger brand, so we need to really define for ourselves who are we talking to and how are we going to serve that set of consumer better than our competitors. So for us, it's a one-line definition of less is more. And that goes well with the DNA of our mother company, Beiersdorf, which has been a 100-year company and has always been the innovator in the market with a lot of firsts to its credit.
And before we let you go, Sunil, why don't you share a marketing tip with us?
Keeping things simple is the most difficult task. And as a marketeer, you sit at the edge of the organization and deal with the uncertain world. So the more you are able to simplify the complex reality outside, the more the organization is able to support you in your vision.
Great to have you with us, Sunil. Thanks indeed. And of course, we hope that the future brings great things for Nivea India as a brand. We'll take a quick break. After that, we review Fast Track's latest ad campaign. Do stay with us. We'll be right back.